Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel SimSumart's online sessions. Don't forget to subscribe my channel for more such videos. And today we are going to do this particular painting just with coffee powder that you have at home. So for this, the material that we need are as in the picture. Make sure to keep all the material ready before we start the painting. And for the detailed description on how to make the shades, I have done another video. Do check that video and get back to this. Keep all the shades ready and take the sponge piece. Fold the sponge piece this way so that we get a very nice texture with it. So, before we start painting any landscape, the first thing that we are supposed to do is draw the line of horizon. Line of horizon is nothing but the line that divides the sky from the land or sky from the water. With the help of the sponge, take the lightest shade that we have. Dip it in and we are going to tap only in the center of the upper part. So it's like a semicircle that we are going to do. Just tap, tap, tap. All we are going to do here is we are going to tap it. So this will be hard enough. We are not doing a feather touch here. So nicely press on the paper and tap. If you can see, it's a rough semicircle that I am doing. Once the first shade is done, go to the second shade and do the next semicircle that is around it. So first a complete tap with pressure, and then once the semicircle is done, we are going to use the rest of it, whatever is left on the sponge, and towards the center where we have done the lighter color, we are going to tap it again with minimal pressure. That is a feather touch. Here we are not giving any pressure, so you have to know the difference. When you're doing the main area, you have to give pressure, and when you're doing the merging area, that is between the light color and the dark color, it will be feather touched. Repeat the same technique for the next tone, that is the third tone. So first, the semicircle around the previous one, wherever it is left, with more pressure. You can see those dots properly. You should give in with pressure. And when you're merging with the previous color that we have done, previous shade, we're going to do feather touch with the leftover color that is there on the sponge. Remember this point properly. That is when you get that nice gradation as well, or else you'll be seeing the difference in the shades. So here the last thing that I'm doing is feather touch only in few areas and near the area of demarcation between the dark color and light color. So that is when you get that thing. So the rest of the place, you can take the darkest shade, darkest tone that we have. As I told, I have done another video how to do this different shades. Check that out and get back to this if you're not getting it. So you have to add more powder, less water for darker tones, and more water, less powder for lighter tones. So keep at least 4 or 5 shades ready before you start. So complete the dark tone as well in the same way as we have done previously. And we'll leave this area for drying before we start with the next layer. Wherever you feel it didn't get merged properly, take very little paint to your sponge and give feather touch in that areas, and it will get merged properly. So once the dark tone is done, we'll leave it like that, and the lower part of the picture is nothing but the water area. We are going to take the lightest tone with the help of a flat brush. I used a 7 size brush, a flat synthetic brush, and we are going to spread it out completely with the lightest tone that we have. If you feel your tone is really darker, all you got to do is add a little bit more water to make it lighter, or if you feel it is really light, add a little powder to make it darker, and complete the total water area in one single shade. Then let's take the next shade, and from corner to center, we are going to pull in strokes. till where you have to do the strokes. For that you have to roughly imagine a semicircle here. If you see the sky area, there's a nice semicircle. That rough imagination should be there, and then you draw the strokes. You can use a pencil initially if you're a beginner, or you can directly imagine and you can do it. So do the same thing on the other side. And if you see, I'm doing the strokes from the corner towards the center. Keep this point in mind and do it. From the corner towards the center, be it left or right, it is always from corner to the center. This point should register in your mind. Complete the strokes similarly as I have done, and then we'll move on to the next shade, the third shade that we have. And this time it's again the same technique, from corner to the center, but this will be only half to the previously done strokes. The previous strokes that we have done, those long lines, it will be similar to that, but half of it. So complete in a similar manner on the left side, on also the right side, and make sure it's always from corner to the center. Keep the strokes as close as possible. This is another trick. You shouldn't keep them very far from each other. You won't get that look. So all you have to do is keep them as close as possible. And if you see few random lines I'm drawing in the center, I'm not going accordingly to the same semicircle I've done. Few lines are longer, few lines are shorter. Keep them that way and complete it. But roughly, you have to make sure the dark lines shouldn't dominate it. Complete it in a similar way. For the lower area, you can completely do it with the dark tones and leave it like that. Once this tone is done, go with the darkest one, darkest shade that we have. Take that, and half of this area should be done again with a similar color. Only half. If you see, only in the corners I'm doing, keeping the lines as close as possible. And one more point to remember, don't keep the lines really similar of the same size. Keep few long lines, keep few short lines. And if you see near the line of horizon, I'm keeping it little darker just to show the difference between the land and the sky. So do similarly. If there's more water, just spread it out like that, how I'm doing it, and complete it. So spreading out is really important. Going from the corner to the center is also very important. Keeping these points in mind, complete whole of the water area, and let's leave that area for drying before we continue on to the next step or next layer that we are going to do. Now let's get back to the sky region, the upper part of it. Before we do, use a pencil to draw a rough outline. We're going to draw trees here, the far off trees that we can see. So for that, I made a long semicircle. Doing the same way, and then let's take the darker tone. Make sure you take the darker tone with your brush. See the way I'm holding the brush, vertically upwards, and you're going to tap it that way. You're not pressing the brush completely, only the tip will be touching, and wherever you have done the line over that, you're going to tap it this way. That is when you get the texture of trees look. So very simple technique, very easy technique. And when you're going to the middle, use a smaller brush, or with the same brush you can use the side, one side of it, and complete it. So do the same way for the rest of the two sides, the left side and right side. So this is just giving the look of the far off trees that are there. And make sure you use the darker tone. Don't use the lighter tones here, because it won't be visible, as our sky is already darker. If you use lighter tones, it won't be visible. Always, for any coffee painting, you have to keep one point in mind, that is, you should always go from lighter tones to the darker tones, not dark to light, because we won't get any lighter tones here over the dark tones. So remember this point and do it. So since the background is a little darker, we are using the darkest tone and completing it. Now since the lower part is completely water, what we should do next? We have to give reflection of the trees that we have done. So I'm taking one tone lighter to the upper tone what we have taken, that this is a tree tone, was the darkest tone. Now one tone lighter I'll take, and I'm pulling down the strokes. keeping my flat brush vertically using only the tip, and I'm just pulling down the strokes. Longer strokes for the longer trees and shorter strokes for the shorter trees. Keep that point in mind and complete all the strokes. Flat brush, vertically pointed, and giving a feather touch, pulling down the strokes. Use only the tip, it gives you amazing results. Once you are done with this, the next one that we are going to do is the tree. So before we draw the tree, make sure you do the outline with the pencil and then get back to this. If you're a beginner, you have to keep all these points in mind and you have to do it. Or if you're confident, you can directly draw the tree. Before drawing the tree, I just want to add some land area here with the help of the sponge and the darker tone. Just tap in there, giving that grassy look and that land area look. Just tap in from left side, and as you're coming to the right side, taper it down. Just similarly the way I'm doing. And then just draw the tree with the help of a pencil. Always remember one point: whenever you're drawing a tree, the base, the bark of the tree should be wider, and as you're going up it should become thinner and thinner, and as the branches are dividing it should become much thinner and thinner. So let's take the darkest tone that we have right now and fill it completely with the darker tone between the lines that we have done, and the outline need not be smooth, it can be a rough outline. And don't keep really straight lines, it won't look natural. Keep them shaky and thicker to thinner as you're going up. Recently I've done a live session on coffee painting, I'll just leave the link below in the description. Just check it out, it's kind of similar painting, but I have shown how to draw the trees in a very simpler manner. Maybe that will help you. And not only this, you can add more branches. Use the help of a pencil first before you draw it, or you can directly do the way I'm doing if you're confident. All I'm going to do is I'm just going to start from one side, pull out the strokes and make it thinner and thinner as I'm ending the branch. Once you're done with the branching of the trees, near the base of the tree, you can just merge the base of the tree with the grass around by just tapping around. With the same brush, you can just tap with the help of one side of the tip. We are done with the major part of the painting, and the rest of it, it's up to you. What you want to do, you want to add a boat, or you want to add birds, or you want to add more leaves to the tree. It's totally up to you on how you want to do. You can finish it accordingly. And remember one thing, whatever you do in the water, reflection is must. Without reflection, it won't look natural. So here, for example, I'm drawing a boat. And after this, I'll make sure I'll draw some reflection to it. For the reflection, always make sure you use the lighter tones. Don't use darker tones for the reflection. So keep that point in mind and complete it. And I would really love to see your paintings. I'm always available on Instagram at @simsumarts. And you can also check out my student works and my student reviews on online classes on my page, and I left the link in the description below. For more such videos, do subscribe my channel, and you can do share it with your friends and family who are interested in paintings, because I'll be doing more such free tutorials and different types of paintings, not only with coffee, with many other medium. And If you want to learn in detail, we have many courses available. For that also, do check my Instagram page. That is completely step-by-step tutorials. And there'll be a number of sessions at a very reasonable price. So those are the priced ones. And you have the free ones in my YouTube channel as well. So it's totally up to you on how you want to take your art to the next level. Then I'll see you all in the next session. Bye.